years. I started working with Silver Young years ago as a result of a chance audition with Lady Anne Tree, who asked me to lunch. And she said, I would like you to work in prison. And actually, you don't say no to Lady Anne Tree. And I drove home thinking, I must be absolutely mad. That's what I said I'll do. And I said to my husband, you won't believe what I've done. I think I've gone completely mad. And he just looked at me and said, was it very expensive? Well, no, actually, it hasn't been expensive. But it has been life-changing. It's taught me to value a lot of things in life that I've taken for granted. And also, I think I realised, unlike a lot of guys who I teach in prison, I wasn't born as a victim of circumstance or a survivor of disaster. And how lucky I am, and it has changed my life. The guys who I teach in Albany are mostly good golfers, and many of them have been on suicide watch, many of them have been perpetual self-harmers, they've been violent and disruptive. And they've just been very depressed and sad. And the moment they join Silver, all that washes away. And you see the most incredible change. Their self-esteem rises. They become more polite. They sometimes, because their sort of confidence and self-esteem grows, they go on to education, which means they can learn to read and write. It really does improve their lives in so many ways, other than just actually the sewing. And I think, too, that prison is very grey and bleak, as all of you know, because you all go in so much. And to have something jewel-like, like some of these in your cell, is just wonderful. It's something that they love looking at and they love sewing. And you just see this incredible change in them. I think needlework is very meditative. And it's calming. I think that's how you see the latest sort of change. And what I really thought about in Albany is that now the prison officers will come to me and say, you know, Fred's a little goblin, would you take him on? And that's a great sort of accolade that they respect it. Mm-hmm. And the governor has said to me actually that he's fully aware of the benefits of financial work. And it is now an integral part of life in Albany, and I'm sure that that's true in other prisons as well, but it just is nice to, you know, hear that. I think, too, that success builds success, and once these guys start to be good at the needlework, they can go on to do other things. And on each wing, I've made a coordinator who stands in for me when I'm away, and again, it gives them a lot of pride to do that, and it enhances life for them. It's quite a sought-after job. They have to earn it. They've got to be good at needlework. They've got to get on with the others, which again is something that they all find difficult socialising. So it has many more benefits other than just producing all this wonderful work. And I think the thing that really pleases them more than anything are the commissions, because they are special, and they're just amazed when they have these wonderful letters from people. There was one guy who said to me, I'm going to sleep with this under my pillow, well, the rest of the life in prison, which is life. He hadn't had a letter for 30 years. You know, and sometimes the letters that they show me bring tears to my eyes, but they look to theirs. And we've had some wonderful commissions in Norway, and are very proud of them. And I think that's a great achievement, because I keep saying to them, you know, the people who are commissioning these things expect the best, they're used to the best, and you're producing it, and it's undeniable, the quality of their work. And in Albany, I'll just swank for a bit, we've made sort of two different types of commissions, really. One for private clients, and of course, in a lot of cases, discretion is very important, people, you know, are not that it's published what they have commissioned. But we've made things for John Stephanides, and a lot of things, he's a financial minister as well. and he's come back twice actually, and he's very skilled even now himself.